Cook. I'm an education consultant with Down Syndrome Victoria, and my role is really to visit children with Down syndrome who are in mainstream schools. I do that on a regular basis, and we offer advice, resources, we'll demonstrate teaching to the teachers in the schools, and also support the families. When I go out and first see a child with Down syndrome, I would go through an observational process first, and it's marvellous how much you can pick up in a very short time. And then I would talk with the teacher and the aide, the integration aide or the teacher assistant, and I'd talk about the program and what they see as the issues, and then we would have a look at strategies appropriate to them. So for example, probably 50% of my time during the week is spent on behaviour support. So then the other 50% would be spread over things like the various academic areas of the curriculum, you know, the fine motor, gross motor, their expressive communication, the receptive communication, teaching them to read, early maths, those academic type areas. That would be the other part of my time. Then on top of that, you might also be involved in student support group meetings, which involve the parents, and where an individual learning program is written for the child and reviewed every so often. So you'd be involved with things like that, and you may also be involved in supporting the families. One of the great things about the job is that you actually do see improvement. And when we're writing goals, one of the things we're looking for is a measure. And I'm always looking to see whether the next time I come, whether the child has moved on. In a way, I don't care where they've started, as long as they have moved on. And we're always looking at measuring that progress. If teachers were interested or wanted to know more about Down syndrome, then they could go to our website, downsyndromevictoria.org.au. And on that, they'll find a whole host of things, like they'll find PowerPoints about having a child with Down syndrome in the classroom. They'll also find references to research articles which back up what I'm saying here today.